Hello dear students, welcome back in our science session and we are discussing our lesson that is sorting materials into group. In the same lesson we are discussing the point that is properties of material. So up till now we have discussed the different properties of materials, we have discussed about the appearance, we have discussed about texture and hardness. So today we will move for the next property of the material, that is what? Soluble or insoluble. So let's discuss what is meant by the soluble or insoluble. So see here, I have certain things over here. So now I will take this beaker. In this beaker I will add some amount of the water, or I will fill this beaker 3/4 with the water, okay? And now I will add some amount of sugar in it. See, now I am adding some sugar in it and I will stir it properly, okay? So after certain period of the time, what we can see, the sugar is get disappear from the water. The sugar is get disappear from the water, or we can say that what, the sugar get dissolved in the water. The sugar get dissolved in the water. So for that property only we can say that what, the sugar is soluble in water. The sugar is what, soluble in water. So we can say that the substances which can get mixed with the water, the substances which get dissolved in the water completely, the substances are called as what, soluble substances, okay? So if you will taste this water, then this water will taste as a sweet, okay? Why it will taste as a sweet? Because here we cannot see this sugar particles, but how it can become so sweet? Because the sugar particles are get completely dissolved in this water, get completely soluble in this water, and it becomes too small and it gets spread all over the water uniformly, and it becomes too small. That is the reason we cannot see the particles of the sugar, but we can taste it, and the taste is what, sweet in the taste, okay? Why? Because the sugar particles are present in this water. So this is about what, soluble property of material. Some substances get mixed into the water and they are called as what, soluble substances. Now we will do the another experiment. Here again I have taken one beaker. In this beaker I will add some amount of the water, and now I will add some amount of the sand in it, okay? See here, I am adding some sand in it. I will stir it, this beaker, okay, and I will keep this beaker as it is for us some time. Then after the some time, what we can say, that the layer of the soil or the layer of the sand gets settled down at the bottom of the beaker. Why is it so? Because this sand is insoluble in water. The sand particles cannot get dissolved in the water. It means what? This sand is insoluble in water. So we can say that what, the some materials are soluble or some materials are insoluble in water. See here, we can see that the layer of soil can get settled at the bottom of the beaker. Why? Because the soil is insoluble in water, while the sugar is soluble in water. Okay, so this is the next property of material, that is what, soluble or insoluble. Okay, so dear students, now we will see the next point from the soluble and insoluble, that is what, solubility of solid in water. Okay, so here I am having certain things that we will do with the help of one activity. We can say that there are the certain solid materials that dissolve in water, and that solid materials which dissolve in the water are called as what, soluble in water. So the solid substances which get dissolved in water, that substances are called as what, soluble in water. While there are the some solid materials that do not dissolve in water, said to to be insoluble in water. So in short, what we can say that there are the some solid materials which get completely mixed in a water, they are called as what? Soluble in water. Or there are the certain solid materials which do not get mixed in the water, they are called as dissolved in a water, they are called as what? Insoluble in water. So to discuss about that, we will do one activity. In this activity we will discuss about the solubility of solid substances in water. So let's start the activity. So here I have taken some things. I am having 5 test tube, I am having some common salt, chalk powder, plastic, also I am having this copper sulfate, and also this is what? Washing soda. So let's start the activity. Here I will take one test tube. In this test tube I will add some water. Okay, same amount of the water we will take in all the 5 test tube. See here, I am adding the same amount of the water in the test tube. Like that, 5 test tube we will fill with the water. And in each test tube we will add the different solid material, okay, and then we will observe each test tube, and from that we'll come to know which solid materials are soluble and which is insoluble in water. So now all these 5 test tube I have filled with water. Now in the first test tube I will add the common salt. Common salt means what? The salt that we are using in our house. And shake the test tube properly. See here, I am keeping this test tube. This is the first test tube, in that we have added the common salt. Next test tube I will pick up and I will add some chalk powder in it. This test tube also I will shake it properly. See here, I am shaking the test tube. Then I will keep this test tube. Now third one test tube I will take. In that I will add some plastic, pieces of plastic. Okay. Okay, here, if you can see here, see these are the plastic pieces are there. These I will keep here as it is. Now I will take as a copper sulfate in the next test tube. Crystals of copper sulfate here I have taken. I will shake this test tube also properly. Okay, here see. Can you see the crystals of the copper sulfate at the down? Okay, I have shake this test tube properly. And I will keep this test tube aside in the test tube stand. And now last one, we will take this last test tube. And in that I will add some washing soda. These test tubes also I will shake it. So here we have add all these solid materials into all these 5 test tubes. Now we will wait for the some time. And after that we will observe all these test tubes. Okay, now after some time, after 5 minutes, we will observe these test tube. See, this is the first test tube, in that I have added the common salt. Now we can see that this common salt get completely dissolved in the water. Okay, so we can say that what? Salt is soluble in water. Here the second test tube, in that what we have added? We have added the chalk powder. But what happened? The chalk powder doesn't get dissolved in the water. It remains in the water as it is. It forms the layer downside in the test tube. It means what? The chalk powder is insoluble in water. In the third test tube I have taken the plastic. We can see that plastic pieces as it is in a water. So it means what? The plastic is insoluble in water. Obviously the plastics will be insoluble. That is the reason the water bottles are made up of plastic, because what? Plastics are insoluble in water. In the fourth test tube we have added the copper sulfate. So here you can see the color of the water is changed. Why? Because the copper sulfate crystals totally get dissolved in the water. So here we can say that what? The copper sulfate is soluble in water. And the last one, we have added the washing soda in the test tube, and that washing soda get totally dissolved in the water. It means what? The washing soda is soluble in the water. So from this activity, what we have concluded? We have concluded that the some solid materials are soluble in water and some solid materials do not, some solid materials are insoluble in water. So the materials which can get dissolved in water, they are called as what? Soluble in water. Some solid materials that do not dissolve in water, they are called as what? Insoluble in water. Now we will move for the next point, that is solubility of liquid in water. Here what we have discussed, solubility of solid material in water. Now we will discuss solubility of liquid in water. So let's start to discuss this point. So now let's discuss the solubility of water with the help of this activity. So for this activity also, again I have taken the 5 test tube, I have taken some water, also I am having this glycerin, then I am having this kerosene oil, also I am having the, this is the glycerin, this is the kerosene oil, this is vinegar, this is mustard oil, and this is alcohol. Okay, so let's perform the activity. What we will discuss from this activity, we will discuss the solubility of liquid in water. So see here, I have taken again 5 test tube. Each test tube I will fill with water with the same quantity. I am adding the same quantity of the water in each test tube. This is the second test tube. I am adding some water in it also. Now I will take the third test tube. This is the third one. This is the fourth one test tube. And this is the last one, that is what? Fifth one test tube. Okay, so like this 5 test tube I have filled with the water. Now I will add each liquids in this particular test tube. So in the first test tube we will add the some drops of the liquid. That is, which liquid I have taken here? I have taken the glycerin. Now see, this is what liquid I have added in it. Now in this liquid I will add some glycerin drops. And I will shake it properly. Okay, after shaking, I will keep this test tube in the test tube stand. Now in the second test tube, I will add some kerosene oil. So see here, I will shake this test tube also. But this, after shaking this test tube, we cannot see this whole liquid can get mixed in the water. We can see the one layer it forms over it. Okay, it doesn't get completely mixed in a water. Again, I will keep this aside. I will take the third one. In the third test tube, I will add some amount of the vinegar. I will add in the third test tube. Then we will shake it and we'll keep aside. In the fourth test tube, I will add some mustard oil, or we can say that we can add any type of the oil in it. I will shake this also, and after shaking I will keep aside. And in the last test tube we will add the some drops of alcohol in it. I will shake this test tube also. Okay, and we will wait for the final. 5 minutes. And after 5 minutes, what we can see that, see here, all these are the 5 test tube. So this is the first test tube, in that we have added the glycerin. So this glycerin get totally mixed in the water. In the second test tube, we have added the kerosene oil, but this kerosene oil doesn't get mixed in the water totally. There is a one layer forms here in the test tube. Okay, we can see this layer forms in the water. So it doesn't get mixed in the water totally. Next one, we can see this is the third one test tube. In that we have added vinegar. We can see that vinegar also get mixed in the water totally. Also, we can see this is the fourth test tube. In that we have added oil, but this oil cannot get mixed in the water completely. It forms one layer over in the test tube. It means what? It doesn't get mixed in the water completely. And last one, in that we have added the alcohol. That alcohol get totally mixed in the water. So from this experiment, from this activity, what we have concluded? That some liquids completely mix with water, they are called as miscible in water. So thus, liquid substances which get completely mixed in the water are called as miscible in water. On the other hand, some liquids do not mix with water and form a separate layer. See here, we can see the separate layer. Okay, some liquids doesn't get mixed in the water and forms a separate layer, and that liquids are called as what? Immiscible in liquid. So the liquid which doesn't get mixed in the soil and forms the separate layer, they are called as immiscible in liquid. The liquids which get completely mixed in the water, they are called as immiscible in water. So for solid, we are using the soluble and insoluble word, and for the liquids, we are using the miscible and immiscible words. Okay, so this is about the solubility of solid in water, solubility of water, liquid in water. And now we will discuss about the solubility of gases in water. So in the water, there are the different gases mix, or we can say that water is the mixture of different gases. In the water, there is oxygen. The oxygen can get completely dissolved in the water, and that oxygen is used by the living things. Like that, we can say the oxygen is used by the different animals and the plants, those who are living in the water. Okay, or aquatic animals and the plants are used that oxygen which is mixed in a water. But there are the certain gases which does not get mixed in the water. We can say that nitrogen is there, hydrogen is there, and methane is there. All these gases cannot get mixed in a water. Okay, so in this way, we can say that the gases can also get mixed in water. Gases which get completely dissolved in the water, they are called as what? Soluble gases. For example, we can say that oxygen. While the gases which do not get mixed in the water or get dissolved in the water, they are called as insoluble gases. We can say that nitrogen, hydrogen, methane, all these are what? Insoluble gases in water. So one more thing is that you are drinking that canned drinks are there, or cold drinks are there. That cold drink is nothing but what? Water and carbon dioxide is get combined together into the can. That is the reason that drinks are also called as what? Carbonated drinks. And that is the reason, don't drink the cold drinks, because it contains the more amount of carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide is good for our body? No, it is not good for our body. So you should avoid the drinking of cold drinks. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the soluble and insoluble property of material. So here we will stop. We will meet in the next video, and this is the time to tell you goodbye. And for today, thank you.